He's the one that put food on your table, clothes on your back. Nobody. Nobody like the Lord. Nobody like the Lord. That's a preach right there. That's a preach right there. Nobody like the Lord. You can call on him in the midnight hour. He'll answer. When you're down and out, he'll answer. When you're sick, he'll be a doctor. When you're in trouble, he'll be a lawyer. Nobody like the Lord. When you're friends, he'll be your friend. My, my, my. Good morning, Galilee. It's a great day to be in the Lord's house. Just one more time. When I thought about it this morning, we're in the second Sunday of 2023. And what came to my mind was the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd. He is my shepherd. He maketh us lie down in green pastures. He lives beside the still waters. Nobody like the Lord. I have a few announcements this morning. It says, the Golden Eagles will meet on Saturday, January 14th at 10 o'clock a.m. in the fellowship hall. Looking forward to seeing each and every one of you, Sister Coleman. Amen? Let's continue to pray for our sick and shut in. Let's keep them lifted up. Let's keep them lifted up in prayer. Let's pray for our families that are going through something right now. Let's pray for Brother Melvin Richardson and Sister Ernestine Perry. Let's keep them lifted up in prayer as well. I'm a firm believer. You pray for me, and I pray for you. Together we can watch God change things. Amen? Amen. Our scripture this morning comes from the book of Psalms. Psalms 34, verses 1 through 3. And it reads, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear therefore, and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. The word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Oh,
Amen. Praise the Lord. Say amen. All together wonderful. All together great. Praise the Lord. It's time to worship the Lord with our tithes and offering. Let the ushers come.
Thank you. everything we got to realize that we are in a battle. We are in a war. Sometime when you're in a war, you get wounded. Thank God that he's long-suffering. Thank God that he watches over us all the time. The Bible tells us all things work together for good. Might not look good, it might not even seem good, but God is working things out in our lives. We have to realize that we're fighting a war. And we cannot stop fighting this war. The devil is out to destroy each and every one of us. Thank God that he's long-suffering. Let us pray, oh good and gracious Father. We come before you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Thank you, yes, for being so good. Thank you for watching over us all night long. And Lord, thank you for waking us up this morning. We realize, Father, we cannot do nothing without you. Lord, we just thank you. And Lord, we realize we don't know how to pray. And Lord, we don't even know what to pray for. Thank God for your Holy Spirit. Thank God for the one that intercedes and understands. Take word to you that we don't even know how to Lord, we thank you. We praise you every day of our life. All in one. You are the one. You are the one that watches over us. You are the one that knows suffering. You are the one that put up with us. When we are not walking and obeying and being submissive to your holy divine word. Thank God that you're long-suffering. Thank God that you watch over us. And Lord, we pray that you would keep us. Bless this church in a special way. Bless the pastor and his family in a special way, Almighty God. Lift them up in a special way. Lord, you know all about us. You know what we need. You, God. You, the God of everything. And Lord, we thank you. Thank you. Thank you for being so good to us. Even in spite of us, you're still good. Lord, we thank you. We praise you. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, we pray. Amen.
Oh, You gotta say yes, he will. Say yes, he will. I got any yes, he will, didn't you? Just turn to your head and say yes, he will. Do I have to cry sometimes? But yes, he will. He'll make ways out of no way. Leave that alone. Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
Yes, he will.
Yes, he will.
Yes!
Yes, he will.
Glory to God.
Spirit heaven.
God had bought the Galilee Church of Mighty Long Way.
Yes, sir.
I bet some of y'all sitting there haven't said a word. I'm going to say it a little bit louder. Galilee had bought the church a mighty long way. Now this church, this message is not for Brian Chapel. It's not for Ebenezer or my father. This message is for Galilee. And the question is, after God has brought us through a pandemic, somebody shout glory. He's brought us a mighty long way. But where do we go from here? We're blessed. And I just want to remind you that through all of this, our finances have been good. There are church doors. I don't know where you know it. 20,000 churches have closed their doors because of the pandemic. But Galilee has kept their doors open. Let me say that one more time. Galilee has been blessed. Y'all must be visiting. Help us, Lord. Let me say that again. Some of y'all visiting. Because this is not member here. I'm not really talking to you. But if you're a member of Galilee, you ought to say, we are blessed. God has brought us a mighty long way. But where do we go from here? Good question. I'm glad you asked. One thing that I do know, you are not where you're supposed to be. Let me help somebody here. Yeah, I know you've been in church and hadn't missed it, but you're not where you ought to be. And what you're going to do in this new year? Lord has brought us to the second Sunday in this year, 2023. Where do we go from here? In this text, Joshua, the first of 12 historical books. 12 books are from Joshua to Esther. It forges a link between the Pentateuch and the remainder of Israel's history. Through three major military campaigns, the Lord had brought Israel, come on up, Reverend, I need you. Amen. Our son coming back home. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Thank you. All right, I hadn't gotten happy yet. Joshua, now the leader. And let me tell you this, when you follow leadership, God will bless you. Or help me somebody. When the man of God follows God for his church, I'm not just only for myself, I am the pastor. And I get orders from God. And when I get my orders from God for Galilee, when you follow God's order, the Lord will bless you. Or help me somebody here. But here in the text, Moses is dead.
Yes, sir.
Moses had led them across the Red Sea, has brought the children of Israel a mighty long way.
All right.
But him. It came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua. Moses is dead. He spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun. Moses ministered and said, Moses, my servant is dead. Now, if we're going to go forward, we must let Moses go. Amen. There's some things in your life that we talked last Sunday that you need to forget those things which are behind and move forward. I said this thing last Sunday. A lot of us make the New Year resolution. Am I talking to somebody here? You made some New Year resolution, you're already broken. Pretty good. I know you ain't gonna get quiet. You said I'm going to church more next year than I did this last year. Two Sundays, you already missed one. Devil listens to you when you make those resolutions. One thing you ought to say, very simple, God, I want to be better in the year 2023 than I was in 2022. God, I want to draw nigh to you because I already know from the word of God that if I draw nigh to you, you will draw nigh to me. Here in the text. Now watch. He says, arise. Did he say that? Moses, my servant, dead. Now therefore, arise. Watch this. You can't go over your Jordan sitting on your rusty vessel.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a witness here? You got to get up from where you are. You watch this. You got to quit being lazy. Preach God. You got to rise, get up, and your Jordans that are front of you, put God first. And you can cross your Jordan. Arise. Get up. Get from where you are. If you don't turn it loose last year, you'll go around bringing it in 23, and you'll wind up with the same thing you had in 22. You'll wind up with the same thing in 23. But you got to get up. Galilee, I'm telling you this morning that you got to get up. Arise. Get up and arise. Go. Over your Jordan. Be not dismayed. Forever be tired. God will take care of you. All of us have some joy. Anybody here? You either had, used to have a Jordan. You're in the Jordan right now, or you're headed to a Jordan. But no matter. God, if you get up, quit crying, quit complaining, and say, Lord, help me. And God will come. May not come when you want. But I declare he'll come right on time. Do I have a witness here? All right, get up. Go over this yoke. Then, when God blesses you, the anointing is on you. Do I have a witness? The blood of Jesus is covering you. Somebody help me here. The anointing is on you. Huh? The blood of Jesus will cover you. Oh, I had to get in there yet. We were coming out of the pandemic. Lord has blessed us. And I had the preacher, one preacher preached here, Reverend McCurdy said, we said that we're covered by the blood. But we can go anywhere. And where we won't go. The same blood that covered you in Walmart. I'm preaching now. I know it's going to be quiet. The same blood will cover you at your park. Your gathering. The same blood of Jesus will cover you. But we always say, well, I will go to church, but the COVID is out. But the COVID is not in Walmart. Big preacher of it. I know. The COVID is not in your parties that you go to. But isn't it strange? The COVID is at church. You got more room to scatter out in Galilee than you have in your homes. Preacher. But I'm going to stay home because I don't want to be around those Negroes. I might catch COVID. And you just left Walmart. Preach up in here. I know you may not like it. But God will take care of you.
Yes, sir.
How many of you believe that?
Yes, sir.
Let me see your hand. How many of you believe that God will take care of you? Watch this. Look at verse 3. It says, can you put that up on the burning man? Would you mind? Verse 3. Every place, Walmart, every place, Kmart, every place, picture with me, every place, I'm going to help somebody, you may not believe me. House of Representatives. Paul the Phoenician. You do this scratching my back, I'll let you just get me in, let me in, be the house speaker. And they swapping this and swapping that and swapping your lives and trying to do this and do that just to get to one position. Is that right? But then, the Bible said, I don't care what they do in the back door and on the cover. It says that where shalt thou any man, I don't care who he is, be able to stand before. Now watch this. Matthew, we got haters. Tell your neighbor, you got some haters too. Who don't want to see you do good. You got haters when God bless you. And a lot of times they close to you. Them haters. When you come in the room, they smile. But they hate us. You got some folk that really put on all hell everywhere. They can put on, they can act like just like they're your best friend. But they hate us. And I'm not gonna worry about my haters. Because my haters don't take care of you. How many of y'all believe that? Your haters, them ones that may be in your family, but they just hate you. The reason why you are today is the Lord bought you. And where you go tomorrow, if it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would I be? Where do we go, Galilee? Where do we go from here? No man. Then God told Joshua that as I was with Moses, I'm going to be with you. Long as you stay in line with God. God will. He take care of you. Now, here's something, I'm not going to hold you much longer. But listen here, verse 6, and I'm getting to the meat now. It says, be strong. Tell your neighbor and say, if you're going to survive, you got to be strong. If you don't make it in times like these, you got to be strong. Do I have a witness? How do I become strong? First of all, we must have the Holy Spirit within us. Oh, somebody help me here now. Now, you got to learn all these other spirits. But you better get the Holy Spirit. Do I have a witness? Be strong. People love weaklings. But you remember, you are a child of God. You be strong and have courage. For unto this people, he set down divine and inheritance. Remember, we are children of God that has inheritance. Do I have a witness? That inheritance comes through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Who on Friday, he died, but he didn't stay long. That very morning, he got up and declared all power in his hand. But then, be good. Do I have a witness? 7th verse, as I get ready to close, only be thou strong and very courageous. You have witnessed, and thou mayest observe to do according to all the law. But then he said, but not from it the right hand, nor from the left, that thou mayest prosper. Turn your neighbor to neighbor. In this year 2023, I am going to prosper. Y'all say that mindset? Tell your neighbor, tell them, I'm going to prosper. Do I have a reason? He said, wherever you go, you're going to prosper. Do I have a witness?
Yes,
now, watch this. I'm not pressing on God. I'm not these other preachers who preach prosperity. Because I believe that prosperity is not only in money. But you ought to prosper in love. Do I have a witness? You ought to prosper. You ought to love folks better than you did last year. Do I have a witness? You ought to care more about people this year than you did last year. Because the Lord has blessed you, you ought to be able to bless others. I'm preaching it. Do I have a witness? Well, I'm getting ready to leave you. That 8th verse said, the book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth.
Yes, sir.
Well, in other words, you ought to keep the word of God in your heart. Do I have a witness there? And you ought to keep it down in your heart. And then he said, meditate therein day and night. Do I have a witness here? And thou may observe it to do according to that. All that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosper, and then thou shalt have good success. Tell your neighbor, I'm going to be successful this year. Tell your neighbor, tell them like you really mean it. I'm going to be successful. God is getting ready to do something in my life. Tell them that God's going to get ready to do something in me. I'm going to have success. It may not be in money, but I'm going to be successful. In everything, let God. Well, my third point is, and I'm getting ready to go, blessed wherever you go.
All right. Yes, sir.
Tell your neighbor, I'm blessed wherever I go. Say it like you really mean it. Say, I'm blessed wherever I go. I'm blessed wherever I go. I'm blessed wherever I go. Around the haters, I'm still blessed. Around the enemy, I'm still blessed. Because I know the Lord will make a way somehow. Is anybody here today? Turn to your neighbor one more time. Say, neighbor, I'm blessed wherever I am. through a Halloween affair, I went to get ready to leave. But I heard of this old preacher. This old preacher, one of the members called him and said, "Pastor, I'm not feeling good. I need you to come over and pray for me." I heard that the pastor got his, put his clothes on. When he got his keys off the door, went out to crank up the car. When he went to crank up the car would not crank. But the preacher said, "Well, she don't stay that far from me. I'm going to just walk to her." And I heard Pastor start leaping, and he started walking. After a while, after about a block, I heard a young man came up to the preacher and said, "Preacher, you got a light." I heard that the preacher went in his pocket, got his light out, and he struck the light and lit the young man's shirt. But I heard that he went on to the members' house, and I heard that he prayed for them, and he came back home. But early that next morning, I heard he looked in the morning news, and he saw where a man had been killed. Right down in the neighborhood, Pastor looked at the boy's picture that was in the paper, and it was the same boy that he struck the light to light his cigarette. It bothered the pastor. He said, "I wonder why he didn't kill me." And I heard that the pastor got up, put his clothes on, went down to the jailhouse. Where the young man was, I heard that he asked the young man, "Say, young man, I see where you killed somebody." The young man, "I did, Pastor." But then he asked the question, "Why didn't you kill me?" I heard the young man said, "When you struck that light, and the light, I looked behind your shoulder, and there was something behind you that kept me from killing you. I come to tell somebody, the Lord will. 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 He'll take care of you." Do I have any witnesses in here? What are you doing? to anyone that don't know him, grant your kindness, move in their heart, God, right now, that they come. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you for blessing us today. But God, move on somebody's heart. They don't have a church home. God, we wish that they'll give their life to you today. Come together with them.
I hope today that you were blessed in a mighty way.
Amen. Where do you go from here? God has. Thank you, Richard. Forgive our young people. But your father will be a henceforth and forevermore. Let us all sing together.